So let's start this problem set by talking about the feather problem. Remember back in Unit 2 that Aristotle said objects fall at a constant speed, and he said that speed was proportional to their mass. Galileo, on the other hand, said that all objects fall with constant acceleration. We seem to have taken Galileo's side in this debate, but is that the right thing to do? After all, a feather or a sheet of paper seems to fall down at what seems to be a constant rate. Let's consider something called air resistance. Now, if you're ever driving in a car on a highway, and you stick your hand out the window, you don't need to have a ridiculously long arm, but it helps, you can feel this force of air resistance. And this is the force of a quickly moving object, for example your hand, feeling the actual individual molecules of air as they slam up against your hand. And that provides an actual force. And it's always opposite the direction of motion. So if the car's going this way, the force is that way. The size of this air resistance force is more or less approximated by an equation like this. Here, V is the speed you're traveling at, and B is some number that depends on maybe the size and shape of your hand or the feather. As you can see, this force grows bigger as your velocity increases. So let's say you have this feather, and it's being pulled down by gravity. As its speed increases, the air resistance force it feels will also increase. What eventually happens is the feather reaches what's called terminal velocity, and that is the maximum speed that the feather reaches. So let's say I have a feather with mass 0.001 kilograms, so that would be 1 gram, and this B, this constant up here, of 0.04. I'm not going to tell you the units, but I bet you can tell me what they are on the forum. I want you to tell me, knowing what you know about motion at a constant speed, what will be the feather's terminal velocity in meters per second?